I welcome everyone back to IIHS Panel 3, Session 6 of Bioinquiry Research Forum 3. I would like to invite Ms. Nostrad Maria, Mrs. Malika Pires, and Dr. Adrian Medina to chair this session. Our first presenter is Fazila Mohamed.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Fazila Mohamed. I'm from Maldives, and I'm going to present the assessment of vectors influencing health, sick, and behavior of Maldivians, with a special insight to health spending related to overseas treatment. Maybe a lot of Sri Lankans might be interested in this because a lot of Maldivians are coming here for health-related treatments. So my abstract number is 15 and pages 29. My care contents are here on this page, and then I'll give you a brief introduction to Maldives health sector, which is the basic health system is based on primary care, and then there are and our basic system actually is relied on doctors and nurses from foreign countries, and then that's the basic problem actually which we have, because we don't have enough trained doctors and nurses for our country who talks in our language. So that's one problem that we have in our country. And there are multiple recognized determinants of health, which can be said as role of biology, behavior, culture, economic, psychological, environment, and social factors, and the interconnectedness of these factors. And the catastrophic health spending on overseas treatment is also a major issue which poses a challenge for Maldivian government. This can be seen in the National Health Account of 2011. It says that we need to do a research on this, why people are traveling abroad for health services, while some of these facilities are still available in Maldives and it's also developing. So the major issues that I could see from different literature, actually there hasn't been any study or anything done on this sector. So most of the literature that I have taken is from other neighboring countries, India, and then some from very far like Africa. But African context does not actually relate to the Maldivian context, because our culture and things are totally different. And the biggest problem that we have is the geography and disparity in delivering the healthcare, because our country is based in small islands where we have only two big hospitals in the capital of Mali, and then people has to be transported from the other rural islands if they have anything, any emergency or anything. So it has actually become a hustle for some people. So that might be a reason why people travel abroad. So there's no general practitioner system. You go directly to shoulder specialist doctor, and we have limited doctors in Maldives. So there's a big pressure on the doctors who are seeing the patients. If you have a pain in your fingernail, then also you go to a specialist doctor. So we have to have a general practitioner system where the people goes first to the general practitioner, and then if referred goes to the specialist doctors, so the burden is less for the specialist doctors. And there's a shortage of locally produced doctors. There's a language barrier where people, the doctors, when in islands, some of the islands, we do not have trained translators. So there might be miscommunication between the patient and the doctor. And then the first concept of Western medicine is haram, which has been coming up recently only, not in the earlier days, only recently it has come up that some of the people are saying that Western medicine is haram. So that has to be later evaluated, because I haven't evaluated that in my research. And the free universal healthcare, people think that due to free universal healthcare, if you have anything, you have to do MRI, CT scan, everything, so that you know everything, rather than just doing a simple test and you know that what's wrong with you. So free universal healthcare, and people are not communicated how this free universal healthcare is going on in Maldives. And several complicated medical treatments also cannot be carried out in Maldives, and refusing to use the available resources. Some people do not want to use the available resources, thinking that the resources in the neighboring countries are better than the resources in Maldives. Because we do not have some resources in Maldives, so that factor has is taken into consideration by the government, and they have introduced the universal insurance for other neighboring countries. Like we can do, if there's some, if there's anything that we cannot do in Maldives, we can do from the neighboring countries. But this concept is miscommunicated. People think that the available resources in Maldives is not that good, and the available resources in the neighboring countries are better than that. So there's a, people are refusing to use the available resources. So based on this, my research question is to investigate the factors influencing health-seeking behavior of Maldivians and catastrophic health spending on overseas treatment. The study also explores healthcare-seeking behavior of the study population, their preferences, characteristics, accessibility to health services, and cases whether their health needs are being indeed met. And then, based on this, my objectives is to understand the human behavior to prove health prerequisite to improve health services by assessing the factors that influence health seeking behavior and taking the account into the why people travel abroad for medical services. So my major based on my major objective, I have some minor objectives which we don't have time to discuss. And the significance of the research I have, it's on two folds. One is to contribute to recognizing factors influencing service utilization in Maldives and analyze the reasons and factors deriving the study population towards foreign treatment, and to improve the information base for better resource mobilization and healthcare development. At this point, I would like to say that my research is a preliminary research. It's not a major research. My conceptual framework is based on Anderson behavioral model. So I have divided my independent psychology. My stress and population is derived from between 21 and 70. The sample size, I use quarter sampling for sampling, and then the basis of quarter is all is as gender, and same proportions of males and females are taken. The data is collected using a questionnaire, and data analysis is in three stages. So when and my results, variable one, characteristics of subject that affects who seeks treatment. So the characteristics that affect who seeks treatment are individual's payment method and their expectations. and characteristics of facility that affects who whose is treatment, and that is cost of care. And 50.8% respondents who sought treatment believe that their health needs were not met by the prospective health facility. This includes all the health facilities. This has direct effect on who seeks treatment. And characteristics of subject that affects service attendance based on type of facility. This type of facility is from all starting from basic healthcare facilities. So this includes age, gender, payment method, and effects also. And variable for characteristics of facility that affects healthcare service attendance based on type of facility. That's perceived quality of care, cost of care, and characteristics of subject that affects health service attendance based on choice. The choice is actually influenced by the quality of equipment's infrastructure. And characteristics of facility that affects health service attendance based on choice, that is medical quality only. Health spending related to overseas treatment. This is the major part in my research. That's the health spending related to overseas treatment are influenced by perception, beliefs, and myths by people. Association between income factor, cost of service, and payment method. There isn't any such relationship when compared to more deviant contexts. And overall consumer satisfaction of health services. The consumer satisfaction of health services is done for theoretical reasons only. And participation satisfaction of modest methodological concerns. So the study is done to assess the factor that affect the health seeking behavior, and limited number of respondents are included, and some vital due to that some vital information is missing. Factors that influence health seeking behavior, which I have been discussed with the variables. So therefore some factors that relate to health spending on overseas treatment are. So yeah, I'm just suggesting the policy makers that healthcare providers and professionals ought to take into account the pragmatic nature of healthcare and dissatisfaction of using an available healthcare facilities in Maldives. So that I have got some suggestions given by the respondents, my references, and thank you, Dr. Kisri, Dr. Nihal, and Dr. George for helping me. Thank you. I'm sorry I took some extra time. I'll be more than happy to answer any of your questions.
I think I missed it, but what was your in numbers for the people that you interviewed?
It's 100 people. 100 respondents. I did my questionnaire online. It's through a web portal, and then I made it sure that the web portal is designed in a way where one person cannot respond to two questionnaires.
So you pre-selected them on the basis that they had sought medical treatment outside?
No. Okay. I selected based on a number of, like, I had a sample selection calculator where through an online calculator which I calculated the number of respondents, and then through that I used a web portal where I have sent to different people. Through that it has gone to a lot of people, and then they could answer the questionnaire, and then the answers come back to me.
My inclusion criteria is
men and women between the ages of 21 to 70.
Okay. And Maldivian
nationals? Yes, Maldivian nationals, yes. Because this is a preliminary research, so somebody else can do a research based on my concept.
Okay.
that was my basic research. So
I would think the Maldivian government would be very interested in funding this.
So anyone from the audience who have a question about why Maldivians comes a lot here?
I'd like to make a few comments. I'm the one who reviewed the paper first. I've never met her. I was really absorbed by this project. I said, what a practical project. What somebody from the Maldives can do to expose the world to the problems that are existing there because of the existing system of maybe payment, the existing way of distributing services. And as Dr. Medania said, I think your paper should be given some special prize in the Maldives. The Ministry of Health and the Nursing Council should really take on this issue and have a lot of subsections that they can gather information on and maybe related to the minister or whoever.
I have done a lot, but it's a limited time. I couldn't explain everyone what it is. So it's a huge research, and everyone can have read it. It's really interesting.
Why
people come here.
Very, very interesting.
The reasons that they have given are quite interesting. And I was even like, I didn't have anything to say why people come and then the reasons that they have given.
This brings down to a very interesting area. So you mentioned that you did not have time to present it here. In the research process, planning is developing the research proposal. Development research proposal is one big area. Second thing is the implementation. Most important thing is, as far as the dissemination. So your everything is perfect, but I found some areas you can improve.
Yes.
In terms of dissemination, you should be able to disseminate in 10 minutes. That's what it is at this level.
Yeah.
So I wish that you improve on that. Mm-hmm. And as Dr. Nihal said, it's a very valid research. I pick certain things in the presentation where the research questions or objectives were pretty easy, kind of. So I think you did not have much time to prepare, I suppose. But dissemination is an important point for the young researchers. Make sure you do this in advance, the presentations, run it through some people. I think we ran through most of the presentations to our colleagues, and she just returned from Australia. We did not have time to, you know, but well done.
Yeah, I just did it in an hour. And thank you all. As you don't have any questions,